Good day, as always, from ChemHelp ASAP. We're now going to talk about pi bonding in molecules. So let's start in the very bottom left-hand corner. We have two carbons. Note that these are both sp2 hybridized carbons. And let's think about what this means. When something's sp2 hybridized, we take the s and the three p's, we mix them all together. We get three new sp2 hybrid atomic orbitals plus a leftover p. Now we know what this carbon's doing with its sp2 hybrids. It's making three bonds, 1, 2, 3, and those are its first bonds to all three atoms it's connected to. But what's going on with the p orbital? Well, the p orbital is making the second bond between these two carbons, and I've drawn that as a big fat bond. It's still just one bond, and that is our pi bond. So let's talk about that pi bond. Energetically, it's almost indistinguishable from other bonds. So we have a carbon, and it has a p orbital, or unhybridized p orbital, atomic orbital. So AO for atomic orbital. And these are going to mix together. And as always, we get two new molecular orbitals. The electrons that came in our p orbitals, our atomic orbitals, go down. It's one big electron, but that's still one electron. And our lower energy orbital is called a pi bond, and our higher energy is the pi star. So again, we get bonding and antibonding orbitals, but what do they look like? Well, for our pi bond, we're going to think of adding the two carbons. Again, we're going to add the p orbitals. And so here's one carbon, and it has a p orbital. And a p orbital has a positive end, shaded, and an unshaded negative end. And there's a carbon next door that has the same orbital. And I haven't drawn these very well, but really, if I drew them a little closer, let's try it again. And let's draw them a little fatter. It's hard to get them to really overlap. What we can see is once these atoms get close enough, and of course they have to be close to bond, we're going to get an interaction in between where these things overlap. And in both the top and the bottom cases, it's constructive. So here we have the positive ends overlapping. That's going to get even more positive. And the bottom, we have negative ends overlapping. That might seem like a bad idea, but more and more negative, it's going to be even a bigger negative region. So these are the atomic orbitals. Remember, these are our p orbitals. What's this going to look like? Let me try to sketch this out. We get great overlap on the positive end and on the negative end. And so here are our two carbon atoms. This is now our new orbital that we created by overlapping these two atomic orbitals. And this is our pi bonding orbital. Note that if we look at the internuclear space, the electrons are going to spend most of their time between the two nuclei. That's a favorable interaction. If we go on the left in our energy diagram, that's why that's a low energy orbital. Okay, what does the pi star look like then? So we're going to do carbon minus carbon. As always, I think of this as carbon plus the negative of another carbon. Let's draw this properly the first time. Nice big fat p orbital on one carbon. And then we're going to add the negative of the other carbon. So we're going to flip the signs. It's going to look upside down. Now where we had all this good overlap before, now we're overlapping positive and negative, both on the top and the bottom. We're going to get cancellation. So what does this look like? We end up getting something kind of like this. I know the silence in videos is always very compelling. So in between where we get cancellation, we get a node. And this is a pictorial representation of what the pi star orbital looks like. So again, we put in two atomic orbitals, the two p's, and we get two new molecular orbitals. And this is our pi star. That's not a good place for electrons because there's very low probability of finding the electron between the two nuclei, and we get a high energy orbital. So this is what virtually all of our pi bonds look like. We've drawn a pi bond between two carbons. This could be a carbon-oxygen pi bond or a carbon-nitrogen pi bond. In both cases, each atom involved in the pi bond brings a p orbital to the bonding picture, and we generate two new molecular orbitals, a pi and a pi star.